Hello and welcome by EA's Art Channel. My name is Ilkjan Wiersma and today I'd like to show you how I painted this portrait of an Indian boy, and therefore I used my oil paints. And I completed this painting on a Belgian linen canvas, and it was the first time I painted on Belgian linen. And I like to say I want to say that I really like this Belgian linen. It's quite smooth and therefore it works perfectly with my techniques and of the techniques I use. And especially on making little details, I found that a smoother canvas can work better for you, because it's for me it's easier to make little details on eyes, for example, and so therefore I like to use a smooth canvas. And let's start the tutorial.
And first of all, I like to start out just blocking in the general shapes I'm seeing. And therefore I use the colors who are quite close to the original piece, but not the exact colors. I will mix the exact colors in the end of the painting, because I have to layer, I want to layer, so therefore I don't start out with the exact colors. I just try to get in the right color range, but most of the times I'm starting a bit darker or a bit more brown, where I should be adding a little bit more of a reddish brown, for example. So therefore I mixed a few different use of color, and just to block in my shapes and build from there. And I'm starting out with blocking in the biggest shapes, like the nose, the eyes, the forehead, and while I'm building up towards the right colors, I also better define my details in that process. So in the end of the piece I will make more little details, and in the beginning I will start with the bigger details. For example, the ear, I'm just blocking in what I see, and I will end up building up those smaller details from there. I found this a quite nice way to paint, and because it's easier for me to see where I need some adjustments in my painting, and I can slowly build up towards the end of the piece. And like here, a little bit shading in the ear, and then I'm moving on to another section. And now I want to block in his eyes. He has very nice eyes, and you can see quite some reflections in the eyes. And to make it easier to define where the other details should go, I'm now starting in to block in those the eyes, so it's easier for me to see where which should go, which detail, and where I need more shading and that kind of stuff. And you can see here I'm building I'm blocking in his teeth, and those teeth weren't white. It's most of the times they aren't white, and his teeth were very dark because of the lightning and the way he holds his head. And I found it therefore quite useful to use the color picker tool on Pixabay, and I have a tutorial about how I do that, and I will have a link pop up by now, so you can see how I use that tool to mix my colors, and to know which color I should use, for example, on those teeth. And like here you see I'm using a little bit more of quite a bit more red and purple in the brown, and that's not the color I want to end up, but there is slowly showing some red in the end of I should say on the reference photo. So I'm laying in a little bit more red so I can glaze over that and I don't lose that red too much. So I accelerate a little bit with that red, but I will tone it down later on. And that's most of the times what I do with different colors, like the other side of his face. It's a bit, a yellow, brown, creamy color, and the color is a bit too off of the right color, but I'm gonna glaze over that, and I don't want to lose my details there. So therefore, I paint it a little bit more. More reddish or more brown or more yellow, and I can easily tone it down later on. And I've found that to be yeah, to be it, to paint it, skin tones a bit easier this way. And also I'm blocking in some color on the edges and on of the canvas. And even though I'm gonna frame this, and you will see on the end of this tutorial how it looks when it this painting when it's framed, but yeah, for if some edges show up, or even though when you frame it, I like to have some color on there, so it's not too obvious, not too white, because it can yeah, distract from the original from the painting. So therefore I like to block in a little bit of color on the edges of my canvas too. And this is a quite a strange face, because he has no eyebrows yet, and it appears a little bit strange, but I first had to get the colors right there, because when I would block in those eyebrows, it is harder for me to blend or to have to blend to layer over another color, because I'm want to let those eyebrows stick out of the rest of the painting a bit more, because it's a different color, and therefore I wait a little bit longer to block the eyebrows in. I'm just trying to get the colors underneath those eyebrows quite right, so I can I don't have to layer over the eyebrows. And what a difference those eyebrows make, and the eyelashes. It's looking much more natural, of course. So yeah, that was one of the things I had to get used to when I'm started painting, that yeah, you have to don't let your brain distract, because there's some parts missing. You try to focus on what's behind those for example eyebrows, so you can build over it easily, and you don't end up layering too much over your hairs, for example. But that's needs some getting used to, especially in the beginning, because it looks quite off, and it can be hard to define your other details. So, but you will get used to it. And I'm coming back to the eyebrows, because now I could because I painted in more of the painting, I noticed that the eyebrows were a little bit too small, and I had to put in a bit more color in the eyes, and I could now see that much easier, because I blocked in the a lot more of the rest of the painting. And yeah, that can be very helpful. So if you for example, you are painting a portrait and you don't know what to do, maybe you need to paint something else to get a better view on what you need on a particular area where you don't know what to do at this moment. But you may need a little bit more of the painting painted in to see what you are missing there. And I work always that way. I paint some things in, and I move on to another section, and I come back to the earlier section I worked on. So because I just saw a few details, I noticed that my colors were off or something like that. It makes it easier to judge your values, your details much better. And for example, I'm in the States, I'm laying in the last details, but I was missing his scarf on his face, and I'm painting in that right now. I was working on this project for hours and I never saw that scar. So yeah, sometimes you just miss something. It was quite easy to paint it in as well, and I needed in the few last layers, but yeah, sometimes you miss things. Well, and this is the end piece. I hope you like it. It's one of my favorites now. I just had such a wonderful time painting this. It's a very special painting. I like the way he looks, and I like that his face is not completely on the canvas. I just like his pose, and yeah, I'm very happy with this painting. And here you see the painting framed on my studio wall, and because of the lighting in the studio, it's not the best photo, because you can clearly see some glare on the painting. But I wanted to show you the frames I like to use for my paintings. It is, I don't know the exact name in the English, but it's the frames where it's where you have some space between the frame and the canvas, and I like how it pulls out your image there. This frame works for me. I think this frame works quite well for your paintings. It gives us just a bit extra, and yeah, I really like that.
So I hope you like this tutorial of my portrait of an Indian boy. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below this video. And if you like my tutorial, and if you like my other tutorials, please subscribe to my channel. I would really like that. And if you like, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and on my own website. Those links will be in the video description. And yeah, for now, I hope to see you at my next video. And thank you for watching. Bye bye.